The first thing that stands out to me is the fact that Bella is a Libra sun, and the sun hates being in the sign of Libra because the sun deals with your ego, your individuality, and your self-expression. That's why it's at home in Leo and exalted in Aries, since these two signs are all about assertiveness. However, Libra is the opposing sign of Aries. It deals with other people. So the sun is in its fall in the sign of Libra because it can manifest as someone who's constantly comparing themselves to other people and looking at what other people are doing. Libra suns can be very socially aware. They seek external social validation. They can have social climbing and people-pleasing tendencies. On a more positive note, this can make someone very charming and attractive. And Belle Thorne, whether you like her or hate her, has a very large online fan base, and she knows how to create online buzz. Libra suns can also be very phony, shallow, superficial. They can focus a bit too much on appearances, aesthetics, and this can translate into putting on a show or even lying to people, especially since Bella is a Libra Mercury and it's conjunct to her Libra sun. So she's very sneaky and she's very good at talking her way out of things, and she always tries to maintain a false air of diplomacy and impartiality at all times. She can be someone who's all talk, very performative, but can back it up with actions. Bella's sun and Mercury are forming a trine to her Aquarius Jupiter, which can reinforce her being famous and having a large fan base. This also reinforces her attention-seeking ways and her purposely putting on a show for people and doing crazy extra gestures in order to get a reaction out of them. Her moon is in its detriment in the sign of Capricorn, and it is squaring her Libra Mercury, and this can make her a liar, a scammer. She can be very cold, selfish, and materialistic. She only means business. She's very transactional, and she actually doesn't have any planets in water signs. Interestingly enough, she's a fire and air dominant individual, so she lacks empathy. Her Capricorn moon also reinforces her being a social climber, since Capricorn is all about achieving, being in the public eye, and reaching the top no matter what. Capricorn moon individuals might also have had a rough and challenging early childhood. They were charged with responsibilities at a very young age, and they were forced to grow up very quickly. And I know that Bella got into the business very early on, and it was out of necessity because her father died when she was 10. Her family was very poor and she needed to help her people out, so she started working as soon as she was able to. So she's definitely a hard worker, I'll give her that. She's definitely an overachiever. And her Libra sun and Mercury are opposing her Aries Saturn. This can reinforce Bella having to grow up quickly. It's also another indicator of her father dying, since the sun represents the father, and an opposition to an Aries Saturn can point to a sudden accidental death, and her dad did die in a traffic accident. Her Capricorn moon is squaring her Libra Mercury, and Mercury deals with transportation in general. So overall, I think Bella's destined for a very rough and challenging life. She's also going to be dealt with a lot of harsh criticism, like people undermining her character, people calling her out on her BS, and these hardships are going to force her to learn how to be more authentic and honest with people, since Saturn points to the lifelong lessons you need to learn, and Aries deals with honesty, straightforwardness, and just being upfront with people without being too abrasive. Bella also needs to learn how to love herself unconditionally and stop comparing herself to other people. Bella has a Sagittarius stellium consisting of her Venus, her Mars, and her Pluto, and this can point to her expressing her femininity in a very sexual and intense, ostentatious way, which can be very off-putting to some, since Sagittarius loves to push boundaries. She's definitely the type to be very open about her sexuality and other taboo topics, and unapologetic about it, which explains her recent foray into the adult film industry. Also, when it comes to love and relationships, she needs her freedom and ability to explore and experiment. And as of right now, Bella self-identifies as pansexual, and she also used to be in a polyamorous relationship with Maud's son and Tiana Manjo back in 2017. her Sagittarius stellium is forming a sextile to her Aquarius Uranus, which reinforces her needing freedom and independence. She's definitely a rebel at heart, and she prefers to go where nobody else is going, even if she looks crazy while doing it. Her Venus is sextiling her Neptune, which again points to her removing boundaries when it comes to love and relationships and embracing her sexual fluidity. Bella has her Chiron in the sign of Scorpio, and this can indicate emotional trauma. And I know that she's been sexually abused early in life, which is very Scorpio themed trauma. And she was also hacked in 2019, and her hacker stole nude pictures of her and threatened to publish them. Chiron is also about healing by facing her trauma and turning it into strength. And I think one of the ways Bella deals with her trauma is by being sexually candid and producing adult movies. It helps her regain some sort of power and control when it comes to her sexuality. And her Scorpio's Chiron is forming a sextile to her Capricorn moon, so working in the adult film industry allows Bella to cope with her trauma. Bella is a Pisces south node, so this reinforces her early life being filled with pain and suffering, her being taken advantage of early in life, as well as her personal boundaries being overstepped. This can also make someone who's used to letting life happen to them and constantly play victim when things go wrong, which points back to her Libra placement and her tendency to always try to talk her way out of things and pull out the activist card when it's convenient. As a Virgo North node, Bella's life destiny is to learn how to set clear boundaries and be in control. She needs to actively find a way to heal and solve her problems herself and stop playing victim. She needs to become more responsible and develop discipline. I hope you enjoyed this reading. Feel free to check out my other natal chart readings, like the ones I did for Ariana Grande and Charli D'Amelio. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to this channel, and I will see you in my next video.